field. There is tension in the West Bank, but I think that the reasons are quite different. First, up to the Israeli point of view, the Palestinians have noticed that they are located in the last of the list of the priority in the Middle East. The Arab countries, the Arab states, forgot them. Don't care. There isn't any common interest and so on.
Yeah, there is Iran and ISIS and Iran, other headaches ISIS, and Russia and Syria, China and Syria.
And the conflict, the new conflict between Russia and the USA and so on. And most important, there is a new leader in the Middle East. The name of the leader is Trump. And Trump, up to the Palestinian point of view, goes together with Prime Minister Netanyahu, goes together with the Israel states, not with the Palestinian side, as was like was in Obama regime. So today the Palestinians feel that they are out of the game. This is first. Second, I think that when we are speaking about the Bahrain conference, the Palestinian will be the only element which will stay outside of the door. Outside of the conference.
Although the rest won't be as existent, you know, Israel is only with businessmen, not with ministers. It's not as important as it was supposed to be.
I agree with you, but the one who is supposed to be part of the game is outside. This is the point. Second, while we are dealing about economic crisis, the reason of this economic, huge economic crisis is not by Israel initiative. The reason of the economic crisis in the West Bank is up to the Palestinian decision. The Palestinians themselves, the PA, have decided to cut the taxes money that, which comes from Israel to Ramallah.
But Dr. Barghouti gave an explanation to that. He said Israel cut, so we had to disagree to continue in this path.
But this is the policy of nothing or all, you know. So when the Palestinians decided not to get any shekel from the Israeli side, it means that the economic situation of the Palestinians are going to decrease. There is I think it's going to be escalated during the next future.
So
if you're asking
you
about
to
that.
The beginning of my question, is it going to the outcome is going to be only demonstrations, or are we going to see violence and maybe even going back to terror attacks? That's something that is in the cards.
I think that violence, a wave of violence, it's not a science fiction. It could be during the next future, during the next months. The circumstances, we have to remember them. Part of it is the, I would say, the end of the role of Mahmoud Abbas. There is a political struggle in the PA. There is influence on the field, you know.
Dr. Barghouti, you want to react on that?
Well, let me explain. First of all, we're not isolated. On the contrary, I think the Israeli-American approach is isolated. You have the majority of the international community. You have Russia, you have China, you have most developing countries, and you have the United Nations and European countries, mainly most European countries, are against this so-called deal of the century and against these plans to kill what the international community agreed about for so many years, which is the two-state solution. Second, we are not isolated in Bahrain. We refuse to go to Bahrain. We refuse to provide the cover to the process of normalization between Israel and the Arab countries at the expense of the Palestinian issue. And I believe that most governments, the Arab governments that are participating, feel so embarrassed. And that is the reason why they have pressured the American side not to invite Israel officially. The Israeli government is not going to Bahrain. And in my opinion, the Arab participation there would be at very low level. And that is a reflection of the fact that these governments are afraid of the positions of their own people.
Yes.
To think that Arab people will take a stand against Palestinians is a myth. And it will not happen. We know that the
Dr. Barghouti, let me ask you a question. But it is no secret that you get less support than you received in the past, and that the Palestinian case is less popular than it was in the past. If in the past you were number one topic in the Arab world, currently, as we mentioned, there is Iran and there is ISIS and there are other problems, refugees, and you are left alone.
We are not left alone, but you are right in the sense that there are so many other problems that have risen in the area. The conflict with Iran, which Israel is trying to encourage, the problem of Yemen, the problem of Syria, that is all correct. So the level of attention to the Palestinian question is less. But you should, it would be a grave mistake for Israelis to think that this less attention to the Palestinian issue would mean that the Arab countries could go further in concluding agreements with Israel at the expense of the Palestinians. This is going to be a very wrong,
Let me
just finish with one very simple point. It is very important for Israelis to understand, if the two-state solution is killed, what's the alternative? The only alternative that Netanyahu has is an apartheid and annexation of big part of the West Bank, maybe 62% of the West Bank. But is that a solution? No, this will lead to a system of apartheid. It will push so many Palestinians to think, okay, you don't want two-state solution. We want, okay, let's fight for ending apartheid in one-state solution.
Yes, so Dr. Barghouti, let me ask Alon Eviatar one question. I'll come back to you to conclude.
If I can clear some point. Important point. I think that when the Palestinian people hear from the Palestinian speakers, like Mustafa Barghouti, like other leaders in the Fatah movement, that they should participate in popular struggle, when you say in Arabic popular struggle,
it means violence.
It means violence. It means violence. It means stabbing. Stones,
said
Molotov.
Openly, that's what you mean, Dr. Barghouti, or you mean non-violent as totally non-violent?
I explained my position. I don't need even to defend it. I am so well known as being the leader that promotes nonviolence more than anybody else. And popular resistance in Palestinian context means nonviolent resistance. But nobody will frighten us or silence us from continuing our struggle. The claim, I know that the Israeli side will always claim that Palestinians are terrorists, and any form of struggle, even the most nonviolent, would be described as violent.
Yes.
The real violence is what we are subjected to at the hands of the Israeli army, at the hands of a system of occupation. Occupation by itself and apartheid by itself is an act of violence.
Point made. Alon, last sentence for you.
We have to hear carefully what the leaders of Fatah movements, which control the areas in the West Bank, saying day by day. They say that the Palestinian side should think another time. Maybe they have to go back to the armed struggle. It's part of the game. We should remember it.